going to turn now to the latest from Valerie Harper. You know, last week we told you about her devastating diagnosis, and we're learning more each day from Valerie about how to confront the most frightening moments of life with bravery and love. ABC's Chris Connolly has her story.
I don't know why I'm putting this in my mouth. I should just apply it directly to my hips.
For years, on two unforgettable 70s sitcoms, she was a strong woman and the perfect friend, supportive, truthful, and riotously funny.
Mary, I came to Minneapolis because of the cold. I figured if I was frozen, I'd keep better.
Then last week, she grabbed our attention with devastating news.
Hello, everyone. I'm Valerie Harper. I recently got an amazingly shocking diagnosis from my doctors that I had an incurable, very rare form of cancer.
And now, with the same heartfelt candor that made Rhoda Morgenstern one of the most beloved characters in television history, she's speaking out about her terminal brain cancer diagnosis for the first time to People magazine.
Because I know a lot of you feel like you know me, that you are part of the Morgenstern family, and I feel I know you too.
Told she may just have 3 months to live, the 73-year-old reassured her public that she is receiving top-quality care from her doctors, along with great and abiding love from her husband, Tony.
My poor husband is bereft, but he's getting through it. Now I don't have a lot of side effects or any pain. When the smoke clears, I'll be standing. Until I'm not, and I'm ready for that too.
Her forthrightness and her positive attitude come as no surprise to anyone who's known or followed her through the last four decades.
Valerie is most definitely interested in spreading awareness of this disease, and she did say it was very important that we have universal health care.
And so, with millions eagerly offering their support, she says she is facing the future head on, and ever hopeful and unafraid.
So, onward. I love you, and know that I'm okay.
For Good Morning America, Chris Connolly, ABC News, Los Angeles.